start the class. So yesterday we discussed about polygon clipping, right? In polygon clipping, one of the example algorithm we discussed about Sutherland and Hodgman polygon clipping algorithm. And now there are four different cases we are going to discuss with respect to polygon Sutherland Hodgman polygon clipping algorithm, right? One, case one, completely if the given the polygon line is inside the clip rectangle, then say endpoint. Completely both the endpoints of vertex is inside the polygon, then you are going to save the endpoint, right? Second one, if exit visible region, which means the point moves from inside to outside, then you have to save the intersection point. First case one, if completely inside, wholly inside visible region, save endpoint, which means the case is into in, both the vertex edge points are into in, inside to inside, then you are going to save endpoint. Case two, exit visible region, which means the one point vertex inside the clipped rectangle and another one outside of the clipped rectangle, in that case you have to save the intersection point. Then number three, wholly outside visible region, save nothing, which means completely the given polygon vertex are outside, you are going to save nothing, nil. Case four, enter visible region, save intersection and endpoint, which means the line enter from outside to inside, both the vertex edges from outside to inside, if it enters, you have to save in your output list your intersection as well as endpoint, both. Okay, the four possible outputs are generated by left clipper depending on the relative position of pair edge points, where we'll see one example for that. If the line edge vertex R passes through outside to inside, in that case you have to add in your output list your intersection point as well as endpoint. Here given two different vertex edges of your polygon line is V1 and V2. The polygon ends moving from outside to inside. In this case, you have to save in your output list your intersection point value and the endpoint value. This is one of the case. Second case, if both the endpoint vertex are inside the clipped rectangle, in this case you have to save only the endpoint, which means both the vertex are inside your clipped rectangle, in this case you have to save only the endpoint value. So endpoint value here it is V2. Next, if the vertex edge passes from inside to outside, inside to outside, between two different vertex edges are V1 and V2, in this case you have to save only the intersection point. So between two different vertex V1 and V2, it passes from inside to outside, so I'm going to save only the intersection point. So here output intersection point value is V1 dash. Okay, next, the fourth case, if the both vertex edges are completely outside of your clipped rectangle, you are not going to save anything. Why? Because it is completely outside of your clipped rectangle, so say nothing, right? So these are all the four different cases. If the two different vertex edges passes from outside to inside, you have to say intersection point and end point. Second case, if both the end point of your vertex are inside, then you are going to say only the end point. Third case, if the vertex passes from inside to outside, so the vertex edges passes from inside to outside, in this case you have to say only the intersection point, right? Then if it is completely outside, you are going to say nothing. These are all four cases appropriate with your Sutherland-Hodgman algorithm, right? And we'll see one example for Sutherland-Hodgman polygon clipping. Take this example. So given polygon edges are 1, 2 and 3. This is a triangle, right? So the triangle with respect to your clipped rectangle, it has the edges of 1, 2 and 3. According to our Sutherland-Hodgman algorithm, we have to calculate the intersection point with respect to four different end points, left, right, bottom and top, in a pipeline process. So what is the output you are going to get in the left clip? That is going to be your input of your right clip. And what is the output you are going to get in the right clip? That is going to be your output input of your bottom clip. And what is the output you are going to get in the bottom clip? That is going to be your input for top clip. So after top clip, that is going to be your final output. Anyway, you can process. Either you can process top clip, bottom clip, right clip and left clip, or you can process left clip, right clip, bottom clip, top clip. So you have to follow a pipeline process with respect to these four N regions. Now we'll go through this example. So given the polygon endpoints are 1, 2, 3. So first, with respect to the vertex edges, we have to calculate the intersection edge as well as endpoint. First, we move with left clipper. The given vertex edge points are 1 and 2. So first, you are going to process with left clip. In the left clip, when you are going to process what first vertex 1, 2, 2. Vertex 1, 2, 2. Here, the line is inside to inside, which means with respect to left clipper, we are going to process. Left clipper means this complete line is inside, and whatever points falls apart from this clipped rectangle, it's outside. Okay, so here 1 and 2 different vertex edges, so line vertex edge inside to inside, in this case you have to save only the end point. So 1 2 2, the vertex edges passes inside to inside, so save only the end point. So you got the value 2. Second, 2, 2, 3. 2, 2, 3. It passes from inside to outside. So you have to save the intersection point. So the intersection point value is 2 dash. Between 2 to 3 vertex edge, this vertex edge passes from inside to outside. So you have to save here the intersection point. So intersection point value is going to be 2 dash. Next, 3 to 1. So 3 to 1, with respect to these two different vertex edges, passes from outside to inside. Outside to inside means you have to save the intersection point as well as end point. So 3 to 1, save the intersection point as 3 dash and your end point is 1. So this is about left clip outputs. Next, you have to perform in a pipeline process right clip. Right clip, what you are going to do? You are going to take the output what you got in the left clipper, that you are going to process as input in a right clipper. So here the clipped edges are 1, 2, 2 dash and 3 dash. So clipped output from the left clipper values are 1, 2, 2 dash, 3 dash and 1. So this you have to take as an input to the right clipper. So right clipper, by seeing the clipped rectangle itself, you know there is no changes in the value. Why? Because when you're going to take right clip, there is no polygon edges are outside of right window. So the value is going to be same. So you have to process right clipper now. Processing right clipper, with respect to right clipper, the inputs are 1, 2, 2 dash, 3 dash, right? First, 1, 2, 2. The vertex edges are inside to inside. In that case, you have to save the endpoint. Endpoint value is 2. With respect to your right clipper. Right clipper, no boundary edge vertex are outside of your right clip window. So all the points are inside. So take, with respect to two different edges, 1 and 2, save the endpoint. Next, 2 to 2 dash. 2 to 2 dash is going to be 2 dash. And 2 dash to 3 dash, it is inside to inside. So you are going to take the value 3 dash. Next, 3 dash to 1. 3 dash to 1. This line vertex edges are inside to inside. So you are going to save the endpoint. Clear? So there is no change in the right clipper. Same polygon edges you are going to process to the next pipeline process of bottom clipper. So the output after you process the right clipper, the output polygon edges are 1, 2, 2 dash and 3 dash, right? So next, what is the output you got here? Same, you are going to process for bottom clipper. There is no change. So same, you are going to process to bottom clipper, right? Next. For bottom clipper, you are going to process with the given edges of 1, 2, 2 dash, 3 dash. So first 1, 2, 2, bottom clipper, the line vertex is passes from outside to inside. So outside to inside, what you have to take? You have to save the intersection point as well as end point. So here, with respect to 1 to 2, it falls from outside to inside. So save intersection and endpoint. So 1 dash comma 2. Next, 2 to 2 dash. In this case, you are going to save only the endpoint. Okay. So endpoint is saved. Next, 2 to 2 dash to 3 dash, 2 dash to 3 dash. This line falls from outside to, sorry, inside to outside. So inside to outside, in this case, you have to save the intersection edge. So intersection edge value is going to be 2 double dash. Next, 3 dash to 1. This is completely outside with respect to your bottom clipper. This is your bottom clipper. So this 3 dash to 1 is completely outside. So you are going to save nothing. So what is the output you got? After bottom clip 1 dash, 2, 2 dash, 2 double dash. This is going to be your output after you processed bottom clipper, right? 1 dash, 2, 2 dash, 2 double dash. Next, you are going to process top clipper. Process top clipper. As you can see, there is no point edges outside of this given polygon edges, not outside of this top region. So there is no change in top clipper. So the final processed value is going to be 1 dash, 2, 2 dash, and 2 double dash. Why? Because all the endpoints are inside. With respect to 1 dash to 2 dash, the edge vertex are inside to inside. So save endpoint, that is 2. Next, 2 to 2 dash, it is inside to inside. So save only the endpoint, 2 dash. Next, 2 dash to 2 double dash, it is completely inside to inside. So save only the endpoint, that is 2 double dash, right? And then next, 2 double dash to 1 dash, this is also completely inside. So you are going to save only the endpoint, that is 1 dash, right? So this is your final output after you process your Sutherland-Hodgman polygon clipping, right? So Sutherland-Hodgman polygon clipping with respect to 4 edge clip, where you have to process in a pipeline, right? So before, the polygon is rectangle, sorry, polygon is triangle, and after you process through the clipped window, you got the polygon values or vertex edge values are 1 dash, 2, 2 dash, 2 double dash. This is your final output, right? Is it clear to all? So through the left clipper, the chronicle order, you can see, and through right clipper, through bottom clipper, and through top clipper. So your final vertex edge of given polygon after you process through Sutherland-Hodgman algorithm, 1 dash, 2, 2 dash, 2 double dash. Is it clear? Yes. Next. So given any polygon through your clipped window, you are going to process the pipeline process with respect to all 4 end regions, you will get the clipped polygon. And this is going to be an efficient algorithm for clipping convex polygons. The edges are clipped against every border line of clipping window, left edge, right edge, bottom edge, and top edge. Edges are processed successfully and allows pipelining of edge, clipping of polygon, as well as pipelining of different polygons, right? And you have to solve this example, where this is one of the example, and example 2, you have to solve using Sutherland-Hodgman algorithm.